Sup, YouTubers out there, and how y'all doing? It's Friday, or let me say, Fri-yay! Hey. All right, I got my skillet heated up. What's she gonna cook today? Guess what? Good old spaghetti. All right, got my skillet heating up right here. I'm gonna add a little olive oil. Oh, yes. Hope everybody is having a wonderful day. Oh, yeah. Hope everything's well with everyone. In spite of what's going on, you know what? We're going to keep our head up. Is that right? We're going to keep our head up. Mm-hmm. Can I get an amen on that? Uh-huh. Grab my spoon here. I try to prepare for these videos, y'all. Because I'm my video person as well. And so I try to always prepare before I do these videos. And it's always something that I forgot to have on hand right when I need it. So anyway, I got my spoon. Okay, so as you see, the oil has beaded up. It's heating up real good. I'm getting ready to add chopped garlic and onion. Oh, honey, hear that sizzle. Yes, honey. Fit it here, and I'm gonna basically scrape off the remaining. Oh, honey, I don't waste anything. I use it all. I don't waste anything. You gotta get creative when you are your camera person also. So this is fresh onion and garlic right here. Now I'm gonna add red and green bell pepper. Mm-hmm. Ah, Christmas colors. Mm-hmm. Yes, I love colorful food. I love my colors. Okay, so this is going to saute to a caramelization. And as with all my dishes, when I do a saute, I always season the saute, because that is what really builds the flavor in your food. Make sure you are using a high heat when you are sauteing your onions and your bell pepper. Okay? Yes. Make sure you are using a high heat. That's looking pretty good. All right. Look at those pretty colors. Mm-hmm. They popping. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate the comments that you guys leave me. They are so uplifting, so encouraging, so supportive. God bless you all. And I thank you so much to all of my subscribers, the ones who started in the beginning, as well as the ones who have recently subscribed, and those to come. God bless you all. I'm just so appreciative. I'm a people person. I love to share my cooking recipes. Now this is an age-old recipe, spaghetti. This is an Italian dish. Yes, it is. And I'm going to prepare it the way the Italians do, which is basically you don't mix your noodles with your sauce. You keep your sauce separate from your noodles. That's basically how this will be. Now that's starting to look real good. Yes. Okay, so now to my saute, I'm going to add my seasonings. Yes. Little seasoning salt. Let's get that going. I eyeball, I don't measure. Little garlic. Now, I'm a garlic lover, honey. I'm very overly generous with garlic. I love it. Even though I put fresh garlic in there, I still love garlic powder. Black pepper. Bam, bam. And I'm going to add parsley. I am a parsley girl. I love parsley. Parsley balances out the flavor of your food, and it gives your food a very attractive appearance. Those little green specks, flaky specks, they're just beautiful. They make your food look professional. Anyway, hope everybody's Fridays are going well. Mine so far so good. No complaints. My mom is doing well. And in future videos, you all are going to see my mom cooking with me. My mother, she still got it. When we were kids growing up, mom did all the cooking. She's an excellent cook. And I told her that I want to feature her on some of my YouTube videos. She was like, eh. God bless my mom. She is 73 years young. I am her full-time caregiver. I love what I do. It is my God-given assignment. I wouldn't change nothing for the world. Oh, yes, honey. I resigned from 2 jobs to take care of my mama. She's worth it. And I don't regret it. I'll do it all over again. I love what I do. I love what I do. That's my heart. She's the only parent I've known. I never knew my father. She's my only parent. And oh, yes, I will sacrifice whatever it takes for my mom. Okay, now that's starting to break down real good. I still got my high heat going here. Wonderful. Look at that. That's reaching a caramelization. Beautiful. Now, next to it, I'm going to add a pound of ground turkey. You can use, hey, ground beef, ground chuck. Hey, whatever you feel floats your boat. I'm going to add the ground turkey. I love ground turkey. But when it comes to hamburgers, y'all, I still got to have that ground beef. I haven't quite adjusted my palate to turkey burgers yet. But when it comes to spaghetti, anything that requires the meat to crumble, tacos, you know, things of that nature, chili, I gotta have ground turkey. Gotta have ground turkey. I like the texture of ground turkey. I like the light flavor. I have been using ground turkey for a very long time, for really over 20 years. And so my palate is well adjusted to it. But you know, the crazy thing is, for some reason, I just cannot adjust to turkey burgers. It's the texture. I think I prefer crumbled ground turkey is what it is, because that's how it is with a lot of the foods we may like or may not like. It's the texture. Our palate may not favor that texture of that particular type of meat or food. But yes. All right, we're getting it in right here. And we're going to let that brown. Yes. And I particularly, I don't like large chunks of meat when I do crumble my ground turkey. I like to let it get very, very tiny. I don't like chunky pieces of meat either. But it's to your preference. Okay, so that's going pretty good. And then I want to show you here in this pot, the noodles are already done. Yes, yes, yes. So I already got the noodles ready. Just wanted to show you that. So, once again, I want to encourage you. Feel free to leave your comments. Thank you to those who leave comments. I welcome suggestions. Oh, yes, like a suggestion box. Feel free. I love it. I don't know if you all can hear the music in the background, but it's smooth jazz. It's like a Motown sound. I don't own the rights to that music. It's playing on YouTube. I love it. For me, jazz is my music. A lot of times I don't want to hear lyrics. I don't want to hear singing. I just want to hear the instrumental music of a song. It begins to soothe the waves of my brain. It begins to calm down the waves of my brain. When so much is going on with this pandemic we're in, and it raises everyone's anxiety and it causes a lot of unsurety of what's going to happen. You know, a lot of times, hey, put your jazz on. Those of you who love jazz, and you know what? Those who haven't tried, I encourage you, try it. It calms your brain down. For me, it lowers my blood pressure. It just eases a lot of that high tension in me, high anxiety. And it's just wonderful. I've loved jazz pretty much all my life. And you know, when I was a kid, I tried instruments. The first instrument I tried to play was the violin. And I was really trying to get kind of good at it, but I kind of gave it up. And you know how you think about stuff you gave up as a child? You kind of like, man, if I would have stuck to it, oh, what I'd be doing today? I would probably be playing in the orchestra. You know, like on the movies when they do those movie scores. I think that stuff is so cool. And then I also tried the flute. Now, I got big lips. I could not get my lips to properly fit over that little hole that you blow to produce the sound of the flute. I just could not get my lips straight, because you have to hold your lips a certain way. I couldn't get it. I gave that up with the quickness. I think I stuck with the violin longer than the flute. Some of y'all can feel me. Some of y'all can feel. But you know, some of you stuck with the instruments, and you're very good to this day. I married a musician. Very talented, plays classic piano, organ, keyboards, drums, bass guitar. Oh, he wooed me over with that bass guitar. Ah! Yes, and became my husband and the father of my children. Oh, absolutely. Now, to this day, we are no longer married, but very good friends. Yes, very good friends. And so, but see, that's starting to look really good. And this is the crumble texture that I prefer, small crumbles. You know, if I could get it down to sand size pieces, I would. Now, this is my T-Fall cookware. I decided, you know what? I'm going to stop cheating myself and treat myself. I'm going to get me some good cookware. I'm going to use a potato masher, but I'm going to be very careful because this is a metal utensil, and I don't want nothing scratching up my T-Fall. This also, mashing it, breaks it down even more. Kind of breaks up some of those bigger chunky pieces. But again, I have to be very careful not to scratch the sides or bottom of my T-Fall because I have an attitude at myself. Okay. That's enough. I'm going to stop right there because I don't want to. Yeah. You see, that's coming together real beautiful. Okay. Now that's done. That's beautiful. Look at that. Look at that beautiful marriage. You have the browning of the ground turkey. You have the red and green bell peppers, the onions, the garlic. Oh, honey, the seasonings. Yes. Yes. And there's another ingredient that I'm going to add. Once after I add the sauce, a lot of you may not know this, but here's the sauce. A lot of you may not know, but there's an ingredient that I'm going to add, which is going to balance out the flavor here of the sauce. Oh yes, honey. Let me add another one. Get that in there real good. Mm-hmm. And you know, with schools being out due to the pandemic and stuff, children are online school. And you know what? This may open up a whole new door to homeschooling for parents who probably never intended on homeschooling their children. Now it's becoming, I won't say an only option, but it's beginning to pop up in so many homes. I've seen videos. just some wonderful things. Even in the midst of this pandemic, people saying how they hadn't sat together at the table for dinner in years. They don't remember the last time they did it. You know, families are coming together. You know, parents are home with their children. You know, it's a wonderful thing. You know, I was a stay-at-home mom for quite a while. And then after my divorce, I had to go back to work. And everything, and yeah, it's all good though. And now I got grandbabies. Oh yes, when your children get grown, it's yes. And so I'm just looking forward to seeing all of my grandchildren. It's really hard, you know, especially when you have children and grandchildren in different cities, different states. It's really hard. It can be really hard, but you know, you just try to keep your head up. Irregardless, keep your head up. All right. Nice sauce. Add it to the combination. Mm-hmm. Now that's going to start getting a little bubbly again. To this, I'm going to add an ingredient that is going to balance the flavor out because you don't want bitter sauce. You don't want that bitterness. I like a nice balanced flavor to everything that I fix. Tell me what you think this is. No, she didn't. No, she didn't. No, she didn't. Mm-mm. No, she didn't put no sugar in there. You bet your bottom dollar I did. Oh, yes, honey. I put sugar in my spaghetti. Yes, darling. Balances out the flavor. It gets rid of the bitter taste. And I also put sugar in my greens, darling. Oh, you better ask somebody. Definitely. Sugar balances out the flavor in your dish, in certain dishes. I use it in my spaghetti sauce as of now, you see. And as well as my greens. I just made greens the other day for Memorial Day. folks was throwing down chai eating greens with their fingers. I'm like, all right now. That's what's up, though. That's what's up. And so, yeah. And you know what, too? A lot of wonderful ideas, inventions, multi-million dollar business ideas is popping up. People, you know, it's like staying at home, you know, gives you time to think. You know, to slow down and start thinking about, you know, business ideas, you know, inventions and things like that. And people are doing well. I'm like, wow, you know, I think it's pretty awesome. And so, yes, there you have it. And so, basically, you just let it come to a nice boil. It gets, you know, it'll get bubbly. And then, you know, you're going to let it, I'm going to let it simmer just a little bit. Oh, that's starting to pop. I don't want nothing popping on me. Simmering underneath. Yes, darling. I'm also going to fry some fish, but not in this video. It'll be the next video. I got some catfish steaks right over to my right. I'm getting ready to prep them up real good, and I'm going to fry them bad boys up. Oh, yes, honey. Dinner tonight is catfish and spaghetti. How y'all doing? Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, you see the bubbliness that it's becoming? That's what you want. That's what you want. That is exactly what you want. Okay? And when it begins to get bubbly, you want to go ahead and cover it because you don't want nothing popping on you. I just got popped. So I'm going to simmer that for a couple minutes here, and then it'll basically be done. You can turn it down, turn your burner down, and let it do what it do, because it's basically cooking all of your ingredients together. It's bringing it all together. So I'm going to turn that down and let it do what it do. Yes, absolutely, absolutely. Mm-hmm. So once again, I welcome your comments, your suggestions. I absolutely love it. The feedback is wonderful. It's encouraging. It uplifts me and it helps me to improve of what I'm doing. Absolutely. Absolutely it does. You betcha. You betcha. Okay. Now, so basically, for the sake of time, usually I would let it simmer a little much longer. I don't really follow a lot of recipes, especially when I'm doing basic down home dishes. I'm just eyeballing things. But just to let you take a peek, it's a nice bubbling simmer. Nice bubbling simmer. And so while that's doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to get some noodles, plate up these noodles here. Okay, come on now, I'm only using one hand. Work with me, noodles. Let me kind of get a little closer. Okay. All right. I'm gonna plate those up right there. Beautiful. All right. So then, while the sauce is still simmering, because you can let it continue to simmer, even after you plate up the first portion, you can still let it continue to simmer. So I'm going to grab some here. All right. There you have it. Spaghetti, Italian style, which is basically keeping your noodles and sauce separate. And as a finishing touch to beautify, I'm going to put a little parsley. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, honey. Presentation. That's my deal. I love the art of cooking, the science of cooking. It's a wonderful thing. Try it, y'all. Hey, this might give y'all a taste for some catfish and spaghetti tonight. All right. Until next time, take care. And how y'all doing?